Welcome back to Magic Duels, I'm your host, Lostwolfe. We're doing the Gideon Jura, or Iora, campaign. He eventually turns into Gideon, so here we go. Still standing for justice even while incarcerated, you fight against the bullying and corruption around you. Hixus, the prison's warden, begins to admire your commitment to your convictions. He starts your training in hieromancy, magic based on order and justice. Okay, this is not a great hand. It has two lands. Okay, we have a new kind of thing here. We'll talk about it when we get there, but this is an instant. We have another instant, okay. So at the moment, he has nothing going on there. We're gonna attack. This is good because I'm leaving the mana open to do something in case I have to. Now, I can't do anything here. And I should maybe have thought about that before I did my attack. But I want to make creatures at the moment rather than spells. So let's do that. Okay, so now normally I would tell you to hide information, but what we're going to do here is I'm going to play the land, and the reason why I'm going to play the land is because I want to get close to being able to cast one of these two. Instants are spells, so everything in magic is a spell. This is a spell, this is a spell, but when they resolve, they end up being slightly different kinds of spell. This is a creature, as we've seen before yesterday, and this is an instant. So when it ends up being cast, it is a spell generically, but then while you're working with it, it's an instant. Now, instants are fast things that happen quickly. In the case of an instant, you can almost always cast it at almost any time. And what you'll see here is I'm going to go into combat. I'm going to put my land down first, though. I'm going to go into combat. He might block, which is the problem. And I want to preserve my two men. So, this spell here that we have, Glorious Charge, means that creatures you control get +1/+1 until end of turn. And that's good. It's sort of bad doing it right now, but I just want to prove the point that you can cast instants at nearly any time. So, we're going to get into combat. He may block. Let's see if he does. He does. Okay, so now I'll pause the game. Timer stopped, and I can react to him blocking. I'm going to do, maybe... Yeah, I'm going to do Glorious Charge. We want to save Show of Valor for later, because it's a slightly more powerful effect on a single creature. So now my guy is a 3-3, his is a 2-2, and his dies. Sure. Now we are more than likely going to lose one of our guys because I'm not going to do the same trick again with Show of Valor. Show of Valor is too important for me to just throw away on a single guy. At this point, anyway. seems right. Let's do this, and we'll make a charging griffin. Eagle of the Watch, Vigilance, okay, this is a new thing we haven't seen before. We've seen flying. What's Vigilance? Well, you've seen how my guys go to the right. They turn to the right whenever I use them. His, when he attacks with this particular creature, Eagle of the Watch, it won't do that. He will be like this, even though he is attacking. Okay, so one other thing, very quickly. It's difficult to see now, but he had two red and two white. And remember how I was saying he can tap this for white and then two of any other combination? Well, he used some of his red there and some of his white to get this done. This doesn't have to be any specific color, just so long as you have two of them. But you must have had white to start it off. Okay, so our griffin should be enough to deal with this guy. So let's see if that is the case. It is indeed. Okay. Let's make our silent artisan. See there, it didn't turn to the right, it didn't tap. This is what that is called, tapping. It did not do that in order to attack. Ooh, here's another one. Excellent. Okay. Now, I'm going to attack with... Ooh, I'm not going to attack with everyone. Lightning Strike deals 3 damage to target creature or player. Now, he can pick a creature, this one, or this one. He's more than likely going to pick the flying guy. Or he can pick me as the player. And he is doing this just before I decide to do attacks so that he wipes out one of my team. Now, I need to decide. I need to make a decision. He's showing me that he's going to hit my walking creature, this guy here. I am actually okay with that. That's a guy I don't mind losing. So I'm going to let that happen. But the choice I might have had to have made was I might have needed to decide whether or not I played Greatheart or whether I buffed one of my guys. I can't do both because I only have 5 lands. But I'm okay with that guy dying, so we're just going to let that happen. Alright. Now, before anything happens here, I expect that he's going to team block. Because he wants my flying guy out of the way. Oh, wow, he did a weird thing. That's fine. We'll have to talk about team blocking a different day. We shall attack. Now notice again that I'm not casting anything because I want to withhold information until the very last point where I have to reveal it. I don't want to show him that I have a charging griffin, and I don't want to show him that I have a show of valor. So I'm going to attack, see what happens, and then plan and act accordingly. Okay, he wants to deal 3 damage to something, probably my griffin. Yes, indeed. So we're going to react accordingly, and we're going to make the griffin bigger. Now, a weird thing is happening here. You can see these guys are arranged from left to right. But what's going to happen is the last thing that ended up on this chain is going to go first, and that would be my effect here, Show of Valor. So this is going to get a 2-4, which is going to make it a 5-7. Then this is going to happen, the lightning strike, and you will end up a 4-4 because it will deal 3 damage to it. I'm going to try and catch these actions one at a time. So there's the 5-7, as you can see. And now this is going to fire off. And now it's a 5-4. And we win. That little bit there at the end was our first introduction to the stack. The stack is super important. It's one of the most... it's one of the reasons why Magic is a great game. But we'll see more interactions with stack-like effects at a later date, probably. That's it for today. Oh, this is my quest. Very good. You can just safely ignore that. Four years under the guidance of Hyksos has shaped you into a powerful combat mage. Hyksos believes your natural talents for wielding magic belies something special about you. He suspects that, like his own mentor, you may be a planeswalker. We're going to talk about that tomorrow, but over here we learn that he is 17 when things change for him. Alright, and that's, as I say, it for today. Thank you so much for watching. I hope that you enjoyed this as much as I enjoyed playing it for you. We're going to play through very slowly all of Gideon's story, and then what we'll do is start speeding it up, because I will need to do much less explaining of the rules once we get past Gideon's story. So I hope that you're with me for that. Thank you so much for watching. I shall see you all soon. Have a wonderful evening, and good night for now, folks.